The most annoying thing about the traditional wedding are those alaga duros and alaga jokos. Alaga duros and alaga jokos, God bless you, God bless the work of your hand. You are talented, you add spice to the day and everything. Yeah. But it's not your daughter that they are marrying now. It's not your daughter that they are marrying. They will be most, do you know, most of the money is these people that take most of the money.
OMG, my lovely husband, you know it in my OMG, and together you can call us the OMG. Sit back, relax, and sip your tea. We keep you company.
Welcome to our channel, OMG. Welcome to our channel, OMG. Welcome to our channel. Welcome to our channel, OMGs, 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 OMGs.
Hi everyone, thanks for watching our video. Today, but before we start, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and comment below. Thank you.
Ah, he did it. Idima.
Really?
Mm, that's my bum bum.
No, it isn't.
It's mine.
Chineke, Idima.
No, that means God is good.
Exactly.
But Mma in Igbo is me. Abi Mma is Mma me.
I listen.
Mma is me. So Idima, good to me, that's what they say Igbo is. Mma is me. So Idima. So Idi in Igbo might mean good, but now I'm mixing Igbo and Yoruba. So Idi, Idima, my bum bum that is on top of you. Ah, no shit. You know, it just everything is worth it. You know, most times when I'm appreciative of you like this, or I'm just in awe of you, or just thinking about you as the one who loves you more, like we established already, you know. When I'm always having like flashbacks. Now the flashback that this ED brought, like, is worth it, man. Like it reminds me of the traditional wedding day, you know.
Oh,
all the dancing, prostrating, you know. I prostrated Gumbo, it's worth it. And it was so fun, you know, like traditional weddings actually.
For you got a lot more action and saw a lot more than I did. Do you know, I'm gonna be honest, right? Traditional wedding for the bride is boring. Yeah. You might come for me. It's for the most part, it's boring.
Are you serious? Our traditional wedding was so fun.
For you, Joseph, in the beginning. Like, for us, we're just like...
Explain, how is it boring?
I was just in the car for most of the time. Or like, you're stuck... Everyone that, like, I've either been stuck in the car or just in a room.
That's true.
Like, just there.
I didn't even think about that.
And you know, if you're in the car, just in case someone wants to, you don't have to wear...
And you know, come out like maybe like 30 minutes to the end.
To the end. To the rice. I want to drink, they've eaten all the rice, all the. And you know, because our one started from the morning, so people had breakfast there, you know.
And but you can be eating the rice. That's not the thing to miss.
But another thing is that imagine if some brides don't have great friends. So imagine, they don't have any friends. So they'll just be there by themselves.
But I get your boring point, but it's not really about the food.
No, it's not like, it's everything is a part of it. The food as well is a part of it. You want to enjoy what people are enjoying out there. It's your wedding day. Yeah. But it doesn't feel the same.
What I would agree with is the fact that it's about you. Do you understand? And you're just there hearing the noise, but you don't even know what is going on.
You don't even hear the noise, baby.
Hey!
So, what I would just agree with is like, so it's your day. Because I feel like the traditional wedding is all about the bride. Because that's who... Let me arrive. It's your day. It's all about the bride. Because the whole conversation is centered around the bride. Because it's the flower of the bride we came to pluck. It's because of the bride we're prostrating and everything. So, I get it when the bride herself is not missing in action, does not even know what is going on, does not even know the price they are pricing now for. Maybe that's not the real price you want to price. Like, you are the one they are prostrating on before, although it's for your parents to take you, but you should see the prostration. You should, do you understand?
Yeah, it's like, it's not really about the brides, no. It's centered around the bride. No,
you don't understand what I'm saying. I'm saying the same thing with you. I'm agreeing with you.
I know you're agreeing with me, but I feel like, you know, in theory, it's supposed to be about the bride. I get that, I agree. But it's not really about the bride, it's more about the families. Like, because, you know, it's the bride's family that is representing everything that they're doing. Like, they're the ones that accept the man, you know. The only thing that the bride really does is goes to pick the Bible. You gotta pick the Bible.
Yeah, but you're not getting my point.
I am.
So I'm saying it is, that day is the bride, it's supposed to be the bride's day. So,
So
the whole point I just said, that I'm agreeing with you on top, is the day is for the bride, but it's now so sad that the bride that the day is for is missing in action. Yeah. So I'm buttressing what you said.
Yeah,
you understand?
Yeah. So like, I always wonder, why is that?
Because when you say it's for the parents, without the bride, the parents cannot. The husband is just interested in the parents and what they have to say because of the bride is coming for. Do you understand?
No,
so that whole day is centered around the bride. Yeah. You know. But I feel, and I want to go deep on this one. I feel the whole founder of this traditional wedding, the person that founded it, the person that brought about this idea that most of us don't know. Parents, you realize now. You people, you are just doing it. You don't know the person that started it. The person that started this thing. Do you want to know?
Oh my God.
Was Laban in the Bible. Because, what's the name of that man that wanted to marry his daughter? Israel, yeah. The person that changed to Israel, Jacob.
Jacob,
wanted to marry his daughter. He told Jacob that, okay, you want to marry my daughter? Work for 7 years. Do you understand? So he works for 7 years, and the daughter that they are working for, he did not even really see the daughter. Do you understand? And he was working for the seven. Even the daughter did not even know that is that they are working for.
And then I tried to trick him.
And I'm sure. See, if we can find the video of Laban's time, you see that even that work, those goats or sheep that Jacob is taking care of, they were not even really giving the daughter. Is her name Rebecca or Kinikon? So after the 7 years, that's don't finish my punchline for me. That's the punchline. After the 7 years. It's now time to now take the bride. They now covered her face and gave him another person. So she missed in the action. So all those things, he now worked another 7 years, full 14 years. So it was 14 years before the wife, who the whole thing was about, got part of the action.
And that's exactly how it feels when you're, it's like 14 years in one day when you're at the bride. And at the end of it, you know, what you groove, everybody's grooving. You come at the end, you know, the dancing part is really nice. I think that's one of the most fun. You dance out and everything. But once, you know, you cry a little bit because, you know, you're leaving your parents and all of that. And then,
so if we can, because where are we to change culture? But if we can, if the writers of the culture, if you people can listen to us, it might make more sense. I understand the fact that, I understand the fact that, okay, the wife is like the jewel of the day. You're trying to keep her and everything. But you can keep her and she'll still be around. Don't let her miss in the action. You can cover her face. In fact, build a glass. Put Ace in the glass and put her inside the glass. But let her be in the hall. Because I'm sure every wife would be happy. They want to see their fiancé doing all the prostrating, all the dance with their friends, you know. So they want to be part of all that fun. Sometimes, I'm sure that some brides will be boning because they'll already be tired when it's their turn to come out.
Bruv, you'd be knackered. Like, you'd just be like, man. And you would just, you know, you'll touch up your makeup like 10 times.
But before we round up, you would think that this is the most annoying thing.
What?
The most annoying thing about the traditional wedding are those alaga duros and alaga jokos. Alaga duros and alaga jokos. God bless you. God bless the work of your hand. You are talented. You add spice to the day and everything. Yeah. But it's not your daughter. It's not your daughter that they are marrying now. It's not your daughter that they are marrying. They will be most, do you know, most of the money is these people that take most of the money. The parents of the bride of the day, that they are the ones that they are supposed to be paying. They collect money from parents of the bride, collect money from parents of the groom,
from the guest,
collect money from the guest, collect money from the friends of the bride, from the friends of the groom, from the bride, from the groom.
Friends of the groom, yeah.
Even the enemies. But yeah, it's so, and some they just do it too annoyingly. I feel the professional way should be for you to actually have a particular price you charge. You know, if you are really that good, then you can be premium. Yeah. People will still come for you. If every other person is charging, say, 150k, you can be charging a 500k or a 700k. If you are that good, they'll come for you.
Yeah.
But let it be that
you don't do it for the money.
let it be that. No, no, that's
no,
not
I mean
point.
Like, no, as in like
you have collected your money, so you won't, you are not coming around that day.
Complete that as well. Yeah,
I was the one talking now. you went to badge into me. She means I should not be badging into you when you're talking. Exactly. So I need to make that point. You are the one that badged into me. Oh yeah, talk what you want to talk. No, no, no. I've already attacked you. So you have collected my attack.
You took most of this video. This video is meant to be about how the brides.
I allowed you to talk. It was when you finished. I said, do you realize one other thing that is annoying?
You had like five other.
No, I'm talking about the alagas. Well, I allowed you to talk throughout this video. Okay, now I've lost the ginger to talk. I'm not talking again.
Need the ginger.
You say I've talked too much.
I didn't say you talk too much.
Yeah, talk what you want to talk.
I wanted to join you in what you were saying that I'm agreeing with you that yes, once you charge a premium, you wouldn't be so like.
Well, you barged in. I didn't make my point. Yes, sorry. Like I was coming from the highlights, and you barged in into, and that's what you always say I do. And now you said I talked throughout the video. Meanwhile, I didn't talk throughout the video. I let you talk for the bride, and I was just trying to talk about the alagas.
I've been on
that alagas. You people collect all the money you want to collect. In fact, take over the whole wedding. If I don't allow the bride come out on that day, alagas. See. Whatever money you have collecting before, collect times five of it in that. Like, it's paining me that it's not your wedding, it's the remaining people that are suffering it. And all you coming wives, know that it's Yetunde that caused this thing. Because I was about to come on your behalf and tell all the alagas not to be collecting money, but Yetunde now has vexed me. So your wedding, Iyabo Owomi, Sandra, you're looking at me, you're laughing. Chidima, she be your wedding's coming up. Alaga, they will collect. Alaga, collect all the money everybody brought. If I collect the dowry.
It's been can you get to the point at least?
That's your point. It's the dancing around to get to the point. That's the spice. They are enjoying it. That's the spice I'm adding. Okay, I've kept quiet. We are talking.
At the last day, and then you're still. Actually, sorry.
Yeah, I've kept quiet. We are talking.
I'm happy. Then they continue.
So, that's all I have to say for today. When you're ready, you round up.
What's been? Is upset? You'll be alright. We always love a good chat, especially Emmanuel. Hope you guys enjoyed this chat.
Oh yes, I'm supposed to walk out.
Thank you for watching. Let us know what you think about this, guys. Let us know what you think about traditional weddings, Nigerian traditional weddings, and what has been your experience, especially brides. What has been your experience? And if you're an alaga, what do you think about what Emma said? That might be a good tip for you. Anyway, see y'all. Just love a bit of attention. See you guys in our next video. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And like this video. Bye. Hey guys.
Yeah, thank you for watching our video.
Thank you.
But before you leave, we are forgetting something.
Have you liked this video? Did you like this video?
Did you comment? Have you subscribed to our channel?
Subscribe. And did you hit the notification bell?
You have. Thank you so much. If you haven't, please just do, yeah?
Do that too.
See you guys on the next video. Bye. Come.
Family, get in the bathroom now.
Bye bye.